heard there are supplies in the area, but there's uniforms skulking around too. Watch each other's backs.
I was sitting in my living room wondering what to talk about in this video. Of course, there's a lot of news regarding The Last of Us 2 and Death Stranding for this week, and I basically covered that earlier this week through my two videos that dropped back to back on Sunday and Monday. I basically was breaking down the initial news, which pretty much still stands, so I don't think I need to go over all of the little bits that dropped, and let's just see what happens tomorrow and Friday. But for today's video, I want to cover something that's less discussed, but I feel should get much, much more shine. Some of you might not like it, but I feel that when it gets better, people might come to appreciate it. Not too long ago, we heard that Microsoft and Sony are partnering up in terms of cloud solutions. I've already pointed out my personal thoughts on this when we first got the news, and I thought that Sony played it smart by working with Microsoft on Azure technology. But when I saw the YouTube fandom just go crazy thinking that Sony was bowing down to Microsoft, which is a whole nother story I don't really want to jump into again. But getting back to this, Azure is really powerful technology, and Sony will be able to use the large amount of Azure data centers worldwide to expand their streaming services reach and capability. Now, before you leave, just think about every other form of media and how in every other one, people fought to stay physical for a bit and then convenience took hold. To be able to stream games and make them feel like they're being played locally, that's the magic. That's the core spot that every video game stream provider needs to hit. Anything less will not work. But when these services are able to achieve that, slowly casual gamers will go first and switch, and then at some point the hardcore will dip their feet in the water. Both Google and Microsoft could possibly achieve this with their many data centers across the globe. They can decrease latency by connecting gamers to their closest data center and communicate directly from there. I've personally worked with Azure at work, and being able to spin up monster virtual machines, servers, fail-safe systems like availability sets, etc. is pretty cool, and this is where Sony can harness Azure technology to improve their PlayStation Now service. More data center reach, more power under their helm, better stability of services will allow Sony to greatly improve on PlayStation Now. Once this is established, we could possibly see greatly improved latency speeds while playing PS2, PS3 games on your PS4, and of course all of them on PlayStation 5, which Sony seems to be pushing pretty hard. To provide you with some insight on the matter, Sony has revealed in their recent investors call how many data centers they currently have. And of course, with more data centers, you have more reach and can be closer to more people. Sony revealed that they currently have 15 data centers across 19 countries globally. Microsoft dwarfs this number with their more than 40 data centers globally spanning across 140 countries. So you can kind of understand how much of an improvement we could be seeing from PlayStation Now if integration with Azure happens, and if Sony combines their data centers along with Azure's, because they're not just going to throw it away, they will then have 55 data centers or more for use across the globe. I know many, including myself, and I am a subscriber of PlayStation Now, are not fans of playing games that feel sluggish and sometimes get so pixelated that you just don't want to come back. I get that. So I have high expectations when Azure and PlayStation Now mix, and so should you. But you guys, let me know your thoughts down in the comments below. Would instant play with solid latency change your mind about streaming video games? Let me know your thoughts down in the comments below, and if you did enjoy this video, please hit that like button. It really supports the page and I really appreciate it. And subscribe if you're new. I got new videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And now I'll check you guys out on the next one. And welcome back to the After Show. This is the part of the video where we have a little fun. Down in the comments below, if you're old, welcome back. If you're new, welcome. For today's thing, what I want you guys to do is to body, obliterate, destroy, harass, and incinerate the comment section with "Make it cheap, Sony." Because right now, PlayStation Now might be a bit expensive for people, but if they hit that price right, I think a lot of people will hop on, especially if they improve that latency speeds. I feel like a lot of people will jump onto it. But yeah, if you feel the same way, destroy the comment section with "Make it cheap, Sony," and I'll definitely heart those comments like I always do, because I appreciate everybody who stays to the end of my videos. And now, I'll check you guys out on the next one.